Okay, so we felt that Nancy was leaving her little box and thus the end of the Malvina era. As much as we adored little boxes and all the artists that did little boxes, and it was very hard to let go of.
Little boxes on the hillside.
We had found another song that would sort of lead us into this new part of Nancy's life for the pilot. We had Aggressive Gunfire just to hit home that we were leaving. And we had chosen the song by Jay and the Americans called Only in America. And we were hoping to get a title company to work up some visuals, and that would be our new opening. And Lionsgate thought the song was too expensive and didn't want to pay for it. And we kept saying, if you don't pay for the song, we're not going to have a song in our opening titles. And we played chicken. I wouldn't say anyone lost, because we came up with these sort of creative intros that gave us more time, and it was fun. So every week we wanted to do something that was sort of thematic to the episode, and you could discover later in the episode what it was and how it applied. Like, this was Bubby's machine. And also in every episode we had some little thing that turned into a pot leaf. It happened at the freeway, this, it happened here. The first one was the border that went through. I'm not sure what changed into a pot leaf on that. You guys can go back and look closer. This was the yard side candle that spun around. And really, we were doing these on the fly. We'd write the script, we'd shoot it, and then we'd say, all right, we got to shoot something quick. Who has ideas? And the whole room would throw stuff out, and then we'd throw it to our production department, and they'd make it happen. And it was amazing. And in the end, I think it really worked out, because it's a kind of a game you can play and try to find out what the opening credits mean in the episode. Like, this is No Man Is Pudding, and we had these great pudding labels made. I also got to keep a lot of these things, which is a nice little collection. The label and the candle and different things. And, how to get the moving pot leaf graphic on it. And for a wrap gift, we gave everyone little weeds flip-flops that had weeds on it. So when you walk, there are flip-flops. It's a collector's item. This was a beach episode. And so it just became sort of a game for the audience and also a game for ourselves, because we'd realized we were in editing and we didn't have a main title. And it's like, quickly, oh, here's genetic Mexican pharmaceuticals. So I thought it'd be fun to. There's a little pot, our little pot leaf. It's just fun. And again, by cutting out 56 seconds or something of opening titles, you have more room for a show. And I still miss Malvina, and I still miss the chance to have all the rock stars, doing. Oh no, her head's a pot leaf. Doing covers, and I really like the Only in America song, but this seems to be our new signature, and I love, frankly, that my name is tied into all of them. And just the crew did an amazing job. So we have all these Mexican heroes on this one, painted in velvet by this great artist that Julie found. And there originally was a portrait of me on the final one, but they wouldn't let me use it. So I have it. It's my Facebook page. And then that velvet is hanging near the bathrooms in the writer's office. This was fun, the condom. It's a fun thing to be able to try to, in the pot leaf in the circle, try to come up with these things each week. It's a little stressful probably for our post department, and our camera crew has to go quickly shoot something that we're imagining on the fly. We've got the best crew in television. This was one of our girls who played Cracklin, Jessica Chapman. She sat with the tattoo for her drug meeting and allowed us to do this. And hopefully we'll continue that this year, because it was fun for us. Let's see what the next one is. Oh, the sander. This was really scary. It's like, wow, how's that going to fit into the episode? And it's kind of dark to find out how. And finally, We have terrifically gift baskets, which plays heavily toward the end. And then we had a crew raffle for who would actually get the gift basket because it was full of goodies. Our writer's PA won. And I still think it's actually sitting near his desk. I don't think he was very interested in the dried fruit and butter cookies. You know, he could repurpose the basket. Anyway, that's the opening titles. I hope you like them.